It's time now for the best high school sports action from the WBCB Sports Network. Catch the best games from Bucks and Mercer County at WBCBSports.com and our Facebook page. Your home for high school sports is right here at WBCB 1490.
Good evening. Welcome to Pennsbury High School as we get you ready for high school basketball on the WBCB Sports Network. Chris Ermer with Gus Barber, Makai Gundy. We got Jordan Hirsch with us, Ben Goldstein helping with some stats as the Pennsbury Falcons host the Bensalem Owls. Suburban One League Patriot Division action on WBCB tonight. It's brought to you by Jefferson Health, McCaffrey's Supermarket. This is the McCaffrey's game of the night. McCaffrey's Food Markets, exceptional every day. Thanks to Penn Community Bank, Rob's Automotive, and Collision. BCWSA, the Bucks County Water and Sewer Authority, St. Mary Medical Center, the Revere Restaurant, Team Toyota, the Peruzzi Auto Group, the Trentonian, Jammer Doors, and the Pennsbury Basketball Boys Parents Club, and DiLorenzo's Pizza on New Falls Road. Big night tonight, the 2-2 Pennsbury Falcons hosting the unbeaten Bensalem Owls, coming in with an overall record of 4-0 in this early high school basketball season, and a 2-0 lead mark so far for the Owls. They were last year's Suburban One League Patriot Division champs, but they graduated 5 of their top 8 players from last year, and 3 of those players, of the 5 that they graduated, were all league players in the area. So they're looking to rebuild and regroup. Meanwhile, for the Pennsbury Falcons, maybe a confidence builder as they come off of a resounding victory against Harry S. Truman, winning 52-26. And Gus, seemed like the game plan the Pennsbury Falcons went in with, they were able to have an early lead and just enjoyed pretty much an easy game against Truman.
Yeah, it was pretty much easy. Anything they wanted, they pretty much got in that game. Something you saw in the Neshaminy game, they were able to get their offense going in that first quarter. But then after that, Neshaminy really clicked on defensive gears, and Pennsbury's offense was just not able to get it going. Well, last game against Harry S. Truman, all cylinders all game long. They were just unstoppable offensively. Ty Kozak, who led the way, just unstoppable with the way he was playing and able to get open for shots. So, yeah, just complete script. So they're going to have to look to take a script out of that game if they want to have success against this red-hot Bensalem.
Yeah, Ty Kozak in that game with a double-double, 19 points and 12 rebounds. And Ryan Zuckerman also doing a good job controlling the glass against the Truman Tigers with 9 boards in that victory. Bensalem coming off of a win against Council Rock North, beating the Indians 54-42. The other league victory that they have is against Council Rock South, beating the Golden Hawks by 20, a 58-38 final score. Both teams are kind of similar in the fact that they're small and speedy teams. So an interesting matchup when you look at these two teams. And I think it's going to come down to which team is able to control the guard play and the pace of action tonight.
Yeah, it's definitely going to be the pace of play. Who's going to be able to dictate that? Pennsbury, they got the size to their advantage. You've seen Zuckerman be able to really be a physical on that board. You've seen Kozak be really successful with the offensive rebounds and defensive rebounds. So against this Bensalem team, who uses their size to their advantage, their smaller size, I should say, and their speed, it should be an interesting matchup today.
Well, they have the music cranked up to 11 here at the Falcons Nest.
Blasting.
It's travel night, so tonight all of the travel players, the elite Falcons elite travel guys, if they wear their uniform, they get in free today. But it is also toy drive night, and they're collecting new unwrapped toys outside the gym, and those toys will go to help the Toys for Tots drive this season. So we got travel night, toy drive night, and most importantly, it's Joey Monahan moment of silence night, as you will remember the former Pennsbury Falcon basketball player who passed away due to a a rare form of cancer and is, you know, still in our thoughts and prayers. And one of the mottos that the Pennsbury Falcons are going by this season is "We Play for Joey," dedicating this season to Joey Monahan's memory. All right, tip-off coming up in just a little bit, and we will hear from PA man Dan Mahoney as the Falcons come out and start their warm-ups. And also we'll take a note at the starters coming up in just a little bit. But talking with Coach Wes Emmy, he told me tonight's a little emotional for him. He gets to come back here for the first time at home and coach this Pennsbury Falcons team that he played for, that his father played for, and a big night to be back here at the Falcons Nest for Coach Emmy tonight. And
yeah, very big night for Coach Emmy. As somebody who is a Pennsbury alma mater myself, it's a big deal to be able to coach your own alma mater, come back in home, get this first game out of the way, especially for such a big night and big matchup it is for tonight. He probably got more jitters than the players do.
It is an early season game, but yeah, it is a big game.
This could be big implications for each team going down forward. If a Pennsbury gets a win tonight, it could kickstart something really special for this team going down. And for Bensalem, if you get this win, you're just continuing this hot run and can really position yourself at the top of the leaderboard.
Yeah, up next for Pennsbury, the other pre-Christmas action that they'll see, Council Rock South on Tuesday, and on next Thursday, it's going to be a girls-boys doubleheader as the Falcons take on Council Rock North, and that also is going to be a very special night as it will be dedicated in part to Council Rock North coach Jesse Krasna and his family going through a very difficult time. And again, that's a boys-girls doubleheader on Thursday as Pennsbury will take on Council Rock North. But this game, they hope to ride a wave of momentum into those two Council Rock games. But first, you gotta take care of a very tough Bensalem team. Well coached was how Wes Emmy described the Bensalem Owls. And you see over the past number of seasons that Coach Ron Morris has made a huge difference when it comes to Bensalem basketball. Again, last year's SOL Patriot Division champs, a 13-3 league mark last season, and a team that plays fast and has good outside shooting. We saw that, you know, that Eric Gonzalez, one of the guys who was really a head turner in their run to that league championship last season.
Yeah, you look at any team, you can talk about how much talent and how much the players mean, but if you have a good enough coach and you have a coach that the players want to play for, that means a lot going a long way. And obviously, seen last year, this year, they have success. And this all starts from the top and the tree, which is coaching.
You know, and I think the other thing, as we welcome Makai Gundy into our Trentonian pregame activities that Coach Morris has done at Bensalem is bring a change of culture. There's a winning attitude now with this team, and they expect big things this season.
Yeah, speaking of winning culture, they're on a winning streak. You know, for all, like you said earlier, they're trying to extend it to 5-0 today against this also very good 10-year Pennsbury team. You know, they have, like you said, you have five players from last year graduating, and you got three coming in. You're hoping they can lead the way with this new guys coming in and, you know, continue that success moving forward.
Yeah, a Bensalem team that describes themselves as small but feisty. And they're going to, you know, rely on that speed and that kind of attitude throughout the season. Certainly a team that's not going to be intimidated by any opponents as they go through this season. All right, start of tonight's game coming up in just a little bit. And we'll step aside, return to the Falcons Nest as the Pennsbury Falcons host the Bensalem Owls on the WBCB Sports Network.
BCWSA customers, former Phillies pitcher Tommy Green here. I played on the 1993 National League champs, so I know a thing or two about what it's like playing on a winning team. BCWSA has all the ingredients. They make it easy for their customers to get automatic updates by text, email, or phone anytime there is a disruption in your service area. You can even customize your alerts by going to bcwsa.net. That's bcwsa.net. BCWSA, your partner for a safer environment. BCWSA, proven.
1490 WBCB Levittown and Trenton, and video stream live at WBCBSports.com. Your home for the best local sports in Bucks and Mercer counties.
Jefferson Health has been serving Northeast Philadelphia and Bucks County for more than a century. Their Frankfort, Tarsdale, and Bucks Hospital locations are there for you with primary and specialty care, emergency care, and of course, inpatient care. Wherever you live, work, or play, Jefferson Health is there with exceptional care. Jefferson is where you are. Call 1-800-JEFF-NOW to schedule an appointment or visit jeffersonhealth.org.
Hi, Merrill Reese reminding you to come back home to traditional Italian cuisine at the Revere Restaurant, 802 River Road in Ewing Township. You'll always feel welcome at the Revere. It's like stepping back in time where you'll feel like you're dining in South Philly or New York's Little Italy. Start your meal with complimentary Hoboken bread. Choose from a menu featuring fresh seafood dishes, succulent steaks and chops, or homemade pasta dishes. You can even eat at the bar. The Revere is open 7 days for lunch and dinner. Private room available for special affairs, plus catering. For reservations, call 609-882-6365. That's 609-882-6365. Come home to traditional Italian cuisine. The Revere Restaurant, 802 River Road, Ewing Township.
Welcome back to the Falcons Nest. As we get set for our Joey Monahan moment of silence, both teams are warmed up and ready to go. Falcons hosting the Bensalem Owls, a battle of the birds, SOL Patriot Division action. Again, Pennsbury coming in with two wins, two losses. Bensalem flying high, 4-0.
Ladies and gentlemen.
And now we turn to PA man Dan Mahoney.
I would like to formally welcome 2005 Pennsbury grad and former Falcon basketball player, head coach Wes Emmy. Before tonight's game, ladies and gentlemen, we have a very special tribute. First of all, I want to welcome everyone and thank everybody for coming out to support us tonight, especially all of our travel players, and you guys look great over there, so thank you guys for coming out. Tonight we're gonna honor a fallen Falcon. 2017 grad Joey Monahan passed away tragically this past September, and Joey was a special young man that displayed all the qualities that we look for in a student athlete. Selfless, committed, dependable, and a competitor. Joey displayed all of those traits, and in spite of his battle against this terrible disease that we now know as cancer. To honor his memory, the Pennsbury boys basketball team is going to be renaming an award that Joey won as a member of our team, the 3D Award. It will now be called the Joey Monahan 3D Award for desire, drive, and determination. Each of our players will also be donning Joey bracelets in memory of Joey, and if you're interested in purchasing them, they will be on sale out in the lobby, and every dime that we raise will go to Coaches Versus Cancer. So please support that cause as best you can, and you can get them out in the lobby. And lastly, before we get going here tonight, we want to honor Joey's family. So if Joey's family would come out to the easel here, where we have a shadow box with his jersey, it's his mother, Sue, brother and sister, stepfather, father, as we have a special award for you guys. For all that you've been through. If everybody would just bow their head for a brief moment of silence in Joey's memory. Thank you.
Pennsbury Falcons basketball renaming the 3D award, which recognizes drive, desire, and dedication. And it's an award that Joey Monahan won. It's now the Joey Monahan 3D award. As we get you closer to the start of tonight's game. And again, Pennsbury, one of the mottos that they're holding on to this season, the mantras that they're thinking about is we play for Joey. Mentioned it a bit ago also tonight, the Falcons collecting new unwrapped toys for their toy drive. And those donations will go to help the Toys for Tots campaign.
Ladies and gentlemen.
And here are our starters for tonight's game.
Welcome to the home season opener between the Bensalem Owls and the Pennsbury Falcons. Please rise for our national anthem. This evening's national anthem will be performed by 2022 grad and former choral and theater member, Ryan Moran.
I think here come the starters.
And now for tonight's starting lineups. Starting at guard for the Bensalem Owls, number one, Eric Gonzalez. Starting at forward, number three, Makai White. Starting at guard, number 11, Antonio Morris. Starting at forward, number 12, Jack Weinberg. And starting at forward, number 23, Idris Zavadago. The Owls are head coach by Mr. Ron Morris. Assistant coaches, Nick Fossil, Austin Nykan, Mike Rongione, Chris Mead, and Mike Stock. And now, the starting lineups for the Pennsbury Falcons. Starting at guard, number one, Teddy Mangan. Starting at guard, number two, Mike Roccavande. Starting at forward, number 10, Connor Taddy.
Starting at forward, number 25, Ryan Zuckerman. And starting at guard, number 15, Ty Kosak. The Falcons are head coach by Mr. Wes Emmy. Assistant coaches, Kurt Bergman, Mike Higgins, Jermaine Major, Lou Cognigny, and John Love. Your officials this evening are Chris Anholt, Derek Roboski, and Corey Lord.
All right, just about set to go for this one. Again, for the Pennsbury Falcons, the 5'10 junior guard, Teddy Mangan, out there with 6'3 junior forward, Connor Taddy, the 6'1 senior guard, Ty Kosak, some size inside with the 6'5 senior forward, Ryan Zuckerman, and Mike Rocco Grandi, super sophomore at 5'11, and he'll be running the point guard for this Pennsbury Falcon basketball team for the Bensalem Owls. 5'6 senior guard Eric Gonzalez, a great outside shooter, getting the start along with Makai White, a 6'2 junior forward. Antonio Morris, he is the one of two of the coach's sons on this team. Antonio, a 5'11 junior guard. Idris Savadago is in the circle to jump center with Zuckerman, and we are underway. The tap is won over to Mike Rocco Grandi. McCaffrey's game of the night here on WBCB, forever in our hearts, Joey Monahan, as this is Joey Monahan moment of silence night, and Mike Rocco Grandi will get it started with a shot from outside. That's no good. Offensive rebound by Zuck. He can't hit, and it's picked up by Ty Kosak. Those guys are really rebounding at a great clip. Coach Emmy crediting Ty Kosak's ability to his like second leaping ability. He's got those springs in his shoulders, and there's going to be an offensive foul. Goes against Ryan Zuckerman for setting that moving screen.
Yeah, Grant, really just second best rebounder on the team, probably behind Zuckerman, obviously, because Zuckerman has the size. That's why I say otherwise, probably, though, for Kosak. So he's got that bounce to him, and nobody really expects it.
He's got that bounce and a great basketball IQ. Savadago sends it into the corner as the Bensalem Owls will get their first touch of the basketball tonight. Shot from outside. That's Gonzalez knocking down the three. You cannot let him open for those outside looks. That time the Owls did a good job moving the ball and getting him a nice opportunity from beyond the arc. Now Ty Kosak. Out to Rocco Grandi, nearly loses it to Gonzalez, keeps it alive. Connor Taddy will launch off the front rim. No, it's a rebound for Kosak. His second of the night, goes left, off glass, yes, and gets the whistle.
A good take right there, going into the inside, able to get the air one. That looks more tight as up at the line.
First team first. Ty Kosak to the line, sweep one.
Yeah, Kosak, good job. He does it, has the ability to finish through contact and gets himself to the line, looking to tie it up. Shot goes in and out. That's one of the things that plagued Pennsbury in the Neshaminy game, poor free throw shooting. Here Gonzalez dribbling around for the Bensalem Owls. Now he'll draw back and bounce it to Jack Weinberg, gives it right back to him, nearly trap him in the corner, and then Bensalem trying to throw it back to Weinberg, throws it away.
Tight defense there, Pennsbury not giving him anything.
Chris Ermer with Gus Barber, Makai Gundy, Ben Goldstein with us, Jordan Hirsch helping with the coverage tonight. Falcons trailing by one in the early going. They try to kick out the Taddy, and it's deflected out of bounds. It'll stay with the orange and black. Head coach Wes Emmy making his home debut at the Falcons' nest as the head coach of the Pennsbury boys basketball team. Right there, Mangan hands off to Taddy.
Connor Taddy for three.
And Connor Taddy hits from distance. It's 5-3, Pennsbury. Taddy had 9 points in their win over Truman, and it's poked away by Zuckerman and taken by Mangan down the floor.
Teddy Mangan
lays it in, makes it 7-3. And Bensalem, they need to talk it over. Timeout on the floor with 5:22 to go in the first quarter. Tonight's game brought to you by DiLorenzo's, the Berg Pizza. 8919 New Falls Road in Levittown, owned and operated by third-generation family member Tyler DiLorenzo. And Tyler uses the same recipes his great-grandparents did back in the 1940s in Trenton's famous Chambersburg section. Try the only original Trenton tomato pie or other gourmet pizzas, including their mustard pie, soups, fresh salads, hot sandwiches, homemade pasta dishes, all served in a safe, clean environment. Eat in or take out, you give them a call and they'll have it ready for you. 215-943-2605. 215-943-2605. DiLorenzo's, the Berg Pizza. They also do catering, and they're in the Vermilion Square, 8919 New Falls Road in Levittown. Back to action. Bensalem needing to call a timeout after that Teddy Mangan lay-in. Now they work it. Here's Weinberg over to Gonzalez. Same spot on the floor. This time shot comes up short, and it's rebounded by Ty Kozak. He always seems like he's in the right spot.
He is always there where he needs to be.
Now dribbling against Makai White, gives it off to Mangan up top. Mangan marked by Weinberg, hands off to Taddy, gets it right back from him, and it's poked away. The Owls with a steal. Weinberg with a Euro step. And he lays it home. It's 7-5.
A beautiful display of the Euro step right there to slide by the defender to get that shot off.
Ty Kozak will bring it up the floor. Marked by Makai White, goes left, over to Zuckerman, and Zuckerman finishes.
Zuckerman. Man,
took a couple of bumps there, no whistle. But he scores and makes it 9-5. Gonzalez dribbling up top. Little teardrop runner is good.
Eric Gonzalez for two.
Got a little back and forth action right now offensively for each team.
Just a little more than midway through the first quarter. And Teddy Mangan is fouled.
Fouls on
Antonio Morris.
Antonio Morris is first team second.
Antonio Morris had quite a bit of varsity experience last year, and now he's joined by his brother, who comes off the bench for this team, Noah Morris. And if that name sounds familiar, that's the same last name as the head coach. It's all in the family. Up top here, Rocco Grandi goes left, out to Mangan. Mangan guarded by Morris, and Morris pokes it away, but pokes it out of bounds.
Out of bounds, Pennsbury ball.
Diving attempt by Jack Weinberg, but he couldn't save it. And the Falcons will inbound. 3:27 to go, first quarter. Pennsbury by a bucket. McCaffrey's game of the night on WBCB. They send it into Mangan. Mangan working against Morris. Intense man-to-man D for both of these teams. Zuck with a pump fake around the perimeter. Connor Taddy, pull-up jumper. That is blocked, and then a whistle. They're going to call a foul. Got him on the arm. That goes against Jack Weinberg.
I thought it was all ball, but then again,
1012, Jack Weinberg, his first team third.
Our officials, Chris Anholt,
number 10, Connor Taddy,
Derek Grabowski, and
two.
Corey Lord. And I think that one was called by Corey Lord, who seemed a little bit away from the play. And I think that might have been one of the things that the Bensalem fans did not appreciate there. 3:02 to go, first quarter. And Connor Taddy hits his first of two.
gives him 4 points and puts the Falcons in double digits. Well, that's a good thing to see. It seems like Connor Taddy has his range tonight. Again, had 9 points in that Truman victory, and Coach Wes Emmy talking about some of the shooting. And a moving screen that time is going to be called against Zavadago.
Offensive foul, number 23, Andrew Zavadago.
Yeah, 4 fouls already for this Bensalem team.
34, Jaden Moffitt in the game for Andrew Zavadago.
He's got to learn how to play without fouling.
Jaden Moffitt off the bench. Zavadago gets a breather after that foul. Mangan races it up the floor, puts on the brakes. Nice little pick and roll with Zuck. His shot partially blocked, barely was able to get it up to the rim. Here's Gonzalez, puts on the brakes. Up top, Morris, pull-up jumper. Off the back rim, no. Rebounded by Zuckerman. Quickly up the floor to Mangan. Mangan lucky to hold on to possession, and then he's going to throw it off of Makai White to hold on to the basketball for Pennsbury.
You know, that was one heck of a recovery right there, to be able to grasp yourself and be able to throw it off the Owl play right there.
Into Zuckerman, now Connor Taddy gives it back to him. Kozak dribbling with 2:12 and counting in the first quarter. Connor Taddy pulls the trigger. A little short that time. Rebounded by Morris. Up the floor here to Moffitt. Moffitt inside. Will send that one high off the glass. And he does get a whistle. A little taking some contact there. Second foul called on Ryan Zuckerman.
Second.
Other thing that happened
to the
Falcons in that Neshaminy game was they got into some foul trouble. Like you said, Makai, they got to play, defend without fouling. That's easier said than done, but you especially can't, and then in the Neshaminy game, they ended up losing Zuckerman and Ty Kozak, who both fouled out.
Yeah, and it could be a variety of things of how you foul. It could be just you being handsy with your hands, or just trying to take like a little cheap undercut with your legs, where you might have your legs under the offensive player.
Jaden Moffitt goes 1 for 2 at the line, makes it an 11-8 game. Falcons on top as Kozak goes left, drives. Off glass, the shot comes up a little bit short. Gonzalez nearly lost possession. Now he's trapped, gives it up to Moffitt. Moffitt with a little drop step and banks it home. It's a 1 point game. Moffitt with 3 big points off the bench for the Owls. Teddy Mangan directing traffic. And now looks over to the bench and the Falcons call timeout with 1:10 to go in the first quarter. Tonight's game brought to you by Jammer Doors and Windows, a fourth-generation family-owned and operated business since 1920 with showrooms in Lawrenceville and Yardley. Jammer provides sales, service, installation of garage doors and openers featuring Raynor garage doors, both steel and aluminum. And Raynor garage doors are crafted for durability. Jammer with entry doors, patio doors, storm doors, and windows. And they do their own work and installation. They don't use any subcontractors. Visit their showroom at 2850 Brunswick Pike on Business Route 1 in Lawrenceville. And in Yardley, their showroom is open by appointment. Call 215-493-7709. Jammer Doors and Windows, 101 years of quality and commitment, an A-plus Better Business Bureau rated. And we thank them for their support of high school athletics and Pennsbury basketball. On WBCB, as we get back to action, Kozak into Teddy Mangan. Now out there for the Pennsbury Falcons is Danny Cohen. And Cohen hands off to Kozak just in front of us. Kozak starts left in the paint, kicks out to Cohen, who traveled.
Traveling violation, Bensalem ball.
Little stutter step to get started. And so he turns it over with 47 seconds left in the first quarter. Now here's Eric Gonzalez directing traffic. Nearly loses it, he does. Rocco Grandi with the steal and the lay-in. Stretches the Pennsbury lead to 3. And maybe now it looks like the Bensalem Owls will draw back, and they're content to work for a good shot right here towards the end of the first quarter.
Yeah, it looks like they're trying to wait to the last second to shoot this ball off to end the quarter.
Antonio Morris up top to Moffitt. Moffitt driving in the lane. No, and Ty Kozak with the rebound.
That's the end of the first quarter.
And that's the end of quarter number one. Pennsbury in front, 13 to 10.
Tonight in the fight against cancer. First, in the lobby, you can purchase a wristband.
Tonight's game on WBCB.
You can also purchase raffle bag tickets.
Also made possible by the Pennsbury Regional Basketball League.
Tickets will be sold through the third quarter, and the winner will be announced.
In its 30 plus years,
the raffle bag,
they wish both the Pennsbury girls and boys the best of luck this year.
76ers t-shirts.
All right, I can't compete against Dan Mahoney. We're gonna break, and we'll be back. Second quarter coming up in just a little bit.
Also, it includes dinner at the Center Club and parking.
Whether you're just getting started, already well on your way, planning for your future, drafting your vision, growing toward greatness, or finding that dreams really can come true, whatever your next steps are, we'll be right here with you. Just like we have been for 150 years. Start here, grow here, stay here. Penn Community Bank. Here we are, and here we grow. Member FDIC.
Falcons on top, 13-10 after one quarter. High school basketball on WBCB, brought to you by Jammer Doors and Windows. And thanks also to the Pennsbury Boys Basketball Parents Club. Tonight's game dedicated in memory of former 2017 Pennsbury basketball player Joey Monahan, who passed away this past September of rare sarcoma. And tonight's game and this season dedicated to his memory as the Bensalem Owls work for a shot. They get it out to Eric Gonzalez.
Eric Gonzalez for 3.
He ties tonight's game 13 apiece with his second 3 of the night.
And that's what he's going to look forward to doing. He's going to try to shoot that outside shot, or if he tries to go in, he's going to look for that floater like he did earlier.
Danny Cohen over to Teddy Mangan, and Ty Kozak goes to the floor. And whistle and a foul goes against Gonzalez.
Team 5th.
Eric Gonzalez picking up his first. And that is the 5th team foul on Bensalem. So Pennsbury could get into the bonus if this trend continues. Outside look, Mangan goes in and out. Quickly up the floor to Moffitt. Moffitt reversed lay-in attempt, no good. And Zuckerman outlets to Mangan. Teddy Mangan working against Noah Morris, who's getting his first minutes. As we're just underway, a minute gone by in the second quarter. Morris goes for the steal. Mangan pull-up jumper. Can't hit from the elbow. It's rebounded by Moffitt. Eric Gonzalez dribbling in, dribbling back out again. And the Owls will set up the offense. Gonzalez step-back jumper.
Eric Gonzalez.
He's got it. Gonzalez tough, now with 10 points.
Tough shot there to stop on a dime, bring it back with the pull-up, Jay. Clean.
I mean, he's got 10 of their 15. Outside here is Zuckerman. Zuckerman passes, but that area was vacated.
Number 11, Antonio Morris.
And they throw it away.
Drummond in the game for the Owls.
Trying to get it to Sam Callahan, but those guys not on the same page.
For the Falcons.
So now it's the Owls by a bucket as Noah Morris inbounds to his brother Antonio. Antonio making some moves, drives high off the glass and good.
Antonio Morris.
Antonio Morris with his first points in tonight's game. Now dribbling here is Sam Callahan. Callahan gives it off to Kozak. Kozak guarded by Morris, and Moffitt comes over. Inside out, poked away, loose, and it's last off of Pennsbury. I think it went off of somebody's knee, and the officials right on top of it goes back to the Owls. Just under 5.5 to go in the first half. We've been going back and forth, and right now it feels like the Owls with a little bit of momentum. They run a weave up top, give it to Antonio Morris. Now handed off to Amir Drummond, but Drummond gets his pocket picked. Stolen by the Falcons. Up the floor to Rocco Grandi. Can't hit the layup. They keep it alive. Rocco Grandi for three. Swish. Falcons needed that. Back to a one-point game. Owls on top, and it's another steal. Sam Callahan with another takeaway. Active hands. And there was a whistle way back there, so.
Owls on number 12, Jack Weinberg, his second.
Oh, we'll go against Jack Weinberg.
He's had Connor Taddy in the game.
Good foul to take by Weinberg because it was pretty much a clear path to the bucket.
Yeah, would have had an easy layup right there if it wasn't for the foul.
But now the Falcons again get all closer to that bonus. Next foul committed by Bensalem will give the Falcons a 1-1. Callahan dribbling up top, over to Rocco Grandi, cuts to the back at basket. Rocco Grandi feeds him, and a whistle and a foul as Callahan goes to the floor.
Foul's number one, Eric Gonzalez, his second.
Gonzalez picks up his second. And here is a 1-1.
Sam Callahan to the line, shooting 1-1. Number one, Teddy Mangan in the game. For Ty Kozak.
Mangan checks in for Kozak. Well, the holiday spirit is alive at Pennsbury tonight. The student section, we got a ton of Santa hats, a bunch of ugly sweaters. Want to send out holiday wishes for everybody. And right there, that's going to be an offensive foul called against Gonzalez.
Yeah, the push off right there with the right arm, trying to make room for himself.
Offensive foul number one, Eric Gonzalez, his third.
Pennsbury now in the bonus.
Yeah, and that's a big third foul on Gonzalez. He's been their leading scorer and the guy who's really made their offense work. He's got to sit down with those three fouls. Teddy Mangan trapped in the corner, tries to throw it off one of the Owls, but it's taken away by Moffitt. Jaden Moffitt over to Antonio Morris, who makes a move on Callahan.
Antonio Morris.
And lays it home. And then that's a foul called on Teddy Mangan. He's called for the clear out.
15, Ty Kozak in the game for Sam Callahan.
So just a little bit more than midway through the second quarter. Bensalem holding on to a three-point advantage. They get it into Moffitt. Moffitt around Zuckerman, misses the first one, keeps it alive. Second shot is blocked. They send it out up top. Here's Drummond. off the front rim, no, rebounded by Taddy.
Pennsbury slowing things down right now.
Taddy over to Kozak. They're trying to slow things down. Bensalem trying to speed them up.
Ooh, step back.
The jump shot bounces around but won't fall. Now Drummond racing down the floor. Hands off to Morris. Morris, Eurostep, goes around the defender and scores. And timeout, a full timeout taken by the Pennsbury Falcons with the score 21-16 in McCaffrey's game of the night. And tonight's game brought to you by DiLorenzo's, the Berg Pizza at 8919 New Falls Road in Levittown, owned and operated by third-generation family member Tyler DiLorenzo, and he uses the same recipes his great-grandparents did back in the 1940s in Trenton's famous Chambersburg section. Try the only original Trenton tomato pie or other great gourmet pizzas, their mustard pie, soups, salads, the sandwiches. It's all good at DiLorenzo's, but that original Trenton tomato pie is outstanding. Call 215-943-2605. 215-943-2605. See what everybody's talking about. DiLorenzo's, the Berg Pizza, and that original Trenton tomato pie at 8919 New Falls Road in Levittown. And thanks also to Jammer Doors and Windows for their support of tonight's game on WBCB. So what do the Falcons talk about in that timeout? They got to try to get their poise back.
Yeah, offensively, they're still in this game. Just defensively, they keep having a couple breakdowns.
I think another thing is you got to remind them that you're also in the bonus. So try to be aggressive as much as you can.
They get it inside to Zuckerman. Zuckerman tries to pass it back, and it is a backcourt violation. Ty Kozak showing his frustration as he pounds the basketball into the floor. Second time they had that kind of play where they... one of the players just moving out of the spot and somebody passing to an open area.
Yeah, just a little miscommunication there.
Now with the dribble there, Antonio Morris with some oohs and ahs, gives it off to his brother who drives, can't finish. And the Falcons up the floor to Teddy Mangan. Mangan across to Taddy, and now Rocco Grandi up top to Ty Kozak. Looked like he thought about pulling the trigger, gets into some heavy traffic, keeps it alive. Runner, not quite, it's poked away. Racing down the floor is Connor Taddy. And he takes it away from Nate Cooper. And whistle and a foul as Teddy Mangan fouled by Moffitt.
Just like Makai said, Pennsbury getting a little bit more aggressive, not afraid that if Bensalem trying to get in that position to foul him.
And if it was aggressiveness or just kind of a wild play right there, it does result in Mangan stepping to the line for a 1-1. He earns the bonus shot. Makes it a four-point game, 21-17 Bensalem. Gets them both. As Morris walks it over the timeline. Kick out to his brother off the front rim, no. Zuckerman with the rebound. Kozak, hesitation dribble, takes it right down the middle and just rolls off the rim. Antonio Morris back to Noah Morris. That shot comes up a little bit short. Mangan, offensive foul. Nice job by Jaden Moffitt to run the floor, get down there defensively, And he is a big guy, not somebody you want to run into. And I think Teddy Mangan thought he would have the speed to kind of get around him. For Moffitt, you got to give him some credit for his athleticism. The big 6'1 sophomore getting the charge. Antonio Morris puts on the brakes up top. Kicks out to his brother on the wing, who dribbles, and now we'll give it off to Moffitt. Moffitt, little shake and bake in the lane. Not quite, tried to extend with that left hand, but couldn't get the bounce. Pennsbury with under a minute to go. Drop it down low on the baseline to Taddy. Driving that time was Cohen. Didn't quite get the spin off the glass I think he was looking for. Antonio Morris hangs in the air and banks it home. Makes it a 23-18 game. Morris with 6 second quarter points for the Owls. Falcons looking for the last shot of the half. Rocco Grandi to Taddy, 3 on the way. It rims out, but a foul is gonna put Connor Taddy on the free throw line.
Big free throws here going into half.
Fouls on number 10, Nate Cooper is first.
Nate Cooper called for the foul.
Taddy to the line, shooting 3.
Could possibly cut this possession into one possession game going into halftime.
And you want to be aggressive and all that, but you don't want to foul a three-point shooter in the corner like that and put Connor Taddy at the line.
Yeah, because you know what they say, if they can hit a three, they're pretty likely to hit a free throw.
Yep.
Yeah, and even especially, you know, ending a half or ending a quarter, you definitely don't want to foul a three-point shooter.
Give Pennsbury the momentum coming out of the second half.
There's Jack Weinberg in the game for the Owls. And 5, Sam Callahan.
Weinberg on the floor for Cooper. And Sam Callahan off the bench for Pennsbury for Zuckerman. So both teams pretty small, and the biggest guy out there on the floor is 6'1". And Connor Taddy knocks down all 3 of the free throws he gets as Antonio Morris races it up the floor. Kick out to Gonzalez. His 3, too strong. And we reach
and the end of the first half.
It's Bensalem 23, Pennsbury 21 in the McCaffrey's game of the night. And we'll step aside for a moment. We'll return to recap first half scoring, give you some first half stats, and get you ready for second half action on the WBCB Sports Network. It's travel night, toy drive night, and most importantly, Joey Monahan moment of silence night tonight. And again, we remind you that, you know, tonight's game dedicated in memory of former 2017 Pennsbury basketball player Joey Monahan. Donations being accepted here tonight, and there's also a 76ers bag being raffled off that contains a bunch of Sixers hats, Sixers t-shirts, 4 autographed player photos, a certificate for 4 lower club level tickets, and that's all for this Thursday's home game, and honoring the memory of Joey Monahan. All right, we've reached halftime. We'll return in just a moment with our halftime activities on the WBCB Sports Network.
McCaffrey's Food Markets, exceptional every day. Family owned and operated for over 40 years, McCaffrey's is part of your community and a very proud supporter of our local high schools. For true value on the freshest meats and produce to their own prepared food department, to everyday savings on your necessary items, McCaffrey's is exceptional every day. And it's in your neighborhood in the Edgewood Village Shopping Center, 635 Heacock Road, Yardley, the Villages of Newtown at 2890 South Eagle Road, and also in Bluebell, Princeton, West Windsor, and the best of McCaffrey's in Doylestown. Are you living with relentless pain? St. Mary has a new way to help.
Knee and hip replacements with a smarter process for faster recovery, earning prestigious awards for quality and value. A rapid recovery program has you walking just hours after surgery. And breakthrough advances, such as custom-fit joints, position you for a longer, pain-free life. 215-710-5888. St. Mary Orthopedics. It's your health. Expect more.
Former Philly Tommy Green, and here's the pitch.
More people are online every day to check and pay their bills. Now you can have your BCWSA utility bill delivered electronically. Enrollment couldn't be easier. Just go to bcwsa.net or call 800-222-2068. With electronic billing, you have control to see your bills whenever you want and enjoy the convenience of viewing and printing up to 13 months of your previous bills. Best of all, the service is free. Sign up for e-billing at bcwsa.net. BCWSA, prove it.
You are not just building a company. You are helping to build your community. For 150 years, Penn Community Bank has been strengthening our region, serving as a trusted partner and resource for businesses like yours. Our team of business bankers can get you where you need to go. Real relationships, expert advice, swift solutions to power your growth. Start here, grow here, stay here. Penn Community Bank. Here we are, and here we grow. Member FDIC, Equal Opportunity Lender.
The Gator, Jerry Blavitt, inviting you to come on by and experience true traditional Italian cuisine at the Revere Restaurant at 802 River Road in Ewing Township. You're always welcome at the restaurant. I mean, it's like stepping back in time. You feel like you're dining in South Philadelphia or in New York's Little Italy restaurant. You can start the meal with complimentary Hoboken bread. You choose from a menu featuring fresh seafood, steaks and chops, or homemade pasta dishes. You can even eat at the bar. The restaurant is open 7 days for lunch and dinner. Private rooms are available for special affairs, plus we do catering. Remember, the Revere Restaurant, 609-882-6365. Again, that's 609-882-6365. Come on home and experience the true taste of Italy at the Revere Restaurant, 802 River Road, Ewing Township.
Your day-to-day life is hectic between having to pick up the kids, make dinner, the countless other tasks that you got to get done. Rob's Automotive and Collision is there to make your life a whole lot easier. Make sure you take advantage of their spacious waiting rooms, the large flat-screen TVs, complimentary coffee and muffins, and free Wi-Fi. So even when you do have to stop, Rob's is there to make you feel right at home. Give Rob's a call today at 215-826-9200 for any of your auto repair needs.
Don't let joint pain bring you down. See how you can get relief at a free joint pain seminar at St. Mary Orthopedics. Joint care experts will inform and answer questions about diagnosing, managing, and treating joint problems and knowing when it's time for a joint replacement. Ready to get back to life? Get to the next free joint pain seminar. Details at stmaryhealthcare.org/joint seminar. It's your health.
All right, number 12, step up.
All right, back at halftime. The Bensalem Owls leading the Pennsbury Falcons 23-21.
There it is, there it is.
And let's take a look at first half scoring.
Guys, you got to keep it in the building.
First for the visiting Bensalem Owls. Leading the way for Bensalem was Eric Gonzalez. Had 2 3-pointers and a couple of buckets from the field. 10 points for Gonzalez. Antonio Morris came on strong in the second quarter. Had 8 points, all of them coming in the second quarter tonight. And then 3 from Jaden Moffitt, who made a big difference off the bench. And 2 from Jack Weinberg for the Pennsbury Falcons. They were led by Connor Taddy, who had 8 points, a 3-pointer, and then he got fouled late in the first half, hit all 3 of his free throws, actually was perfect from the line, went 5 for 5 from the stripe. Connor Taddy with 8 points, 5 coming from Mike Rocco Grandi, and 4 for Teddy Mangan.
Let's hit it. What next? Who's next?
2 points for Ty Kozak and 2 for Ryan Zuckerman.
Here we go.
Turnovers, 4 for Pennsbury. And for Bensalem, they turned the ball over just one time in the first half. And we'll take a look at rebounds and assists when we return in just a little bit with more of our halftime activities on the WBCB Sports Network.
You are not just building a company. You are helping to build your community. For 150 years, Penn Community Bank has been strengthening our region, serving as a trusted partner and resource for businesses like yours. Our team of business bankers can get you where you need to go. Real relationships, expert advice, swift solutions to power your growth. Start here, grow here, stay here. Penn Community Bank. Here we are, and here we grow. Member FDIC, Equal Opportunity Lender.
The Gator, Jerry Blavitt, inviting you to come on by and experience true traditional Italian cuisine at the Revere Restaurant at 802 River Road in Ewing Township. You're always welcome at the restaurant. I mean, it's like stepping back in time. You feel like you're dining in South Philadelphia or in New York's Little Italy restaurant. You can start the meal with complimentary Hoboken bread. You choose from a menu featuring fresh seafood, steaks and chops, or homemade pasta dishes. You can even eat at the bar. The restaurant is open 7 days for lunch and dinner. Private rooms are available for special affairs. Plus, we do catering. Remember, the Revere Restaurant, 609-882-6365. Again, that's 609-882-6365. Come on home and experience the true taste of Italy at the Revere Restaurant, 802 River Road, Ewing Township.
Your day-to-day life is hectic between having to pick up the kids, make dinner, the countless other tasks that you got to get done. Rob's Automotive and Collision is there to make your life a whole lot easier. Make sure you take advantage of their spacious waiting rooms, the large flat-screen TVs, complimentary coffee and muffins, and free Wi-Fi. So even when you do have to stop, Rob's is there to make you feel right at home. Give Rob's a call today at 215-826-9200 for any of your auto repair needs.
Don't let joint pain bring you down. See how you can get relief at a free joint pain seminar at St. Mary Orthopedics. Joint care experts will inform and answer questions about diagnosing, managing, and treating joint problems and knowing when it's time for a joint replacement. Ready to get back to life? Get to the next free joint pain seminar. Details at stmaryhealthcare.org/joint seminar. It's your health. Expect more.
Rebounding in the first half, had 6 rebounds for Ryan Zuckerman for Pennsbury, 4 from Ty Kozak for Bensalem. It was Makai White leading the way when it comes to rebounding for the Owls. You mentioned the turnovers. Pennsbury with 4 turnovers, Bensalem with just 1 in the first half. And it's Bensalem by a bucket as we get the third quarter underway. Zuckerman hands off to Kozak. Kozak can't finish but keeps it alive. Connor Taddy for 3. He's got it.
That's what we talked about going into the half with the momentum. Pennsbury coming out in the second half, really finding their stride now.
Falcons up 24-23. Connor Taddy with 11 points to pace the Falcons. A foul on the floor away from the ball. That's called against Mike Rocco Grandi. Comes with just about a half minute gone in the third quarter. And Gonzalez bounces it in to White. Up top to Morris. It's poked away by Connor Taddy, who steals it.
Ooh,
goes between two defenders.
Transition.
Drives and is fouled in his layup attempt. So give him 2 shots at the line.
Had 2 defenders on him. Split the gap and got through him. Wow, what a move to get away from those guys.
Having a big game tonight. And he continues his good shooting from the line.
Keeps playing like this tonight, he might earn himself a gift card.
Yeah, our DiLorenzo's player of the game will join us after tonight's contest. As Connor Taddy knocks them both down. Makes it 26-23. driving that time. Antonio Morris couldn't quite get the bounce. Gonzalez steals it away. Zuckerman tries to take it right back, and then Morris goes up high to bank it home. That gives him 10 points in tonight's game and draws the Owls to within one. Connor Taddy pulls up at the free throw line and knocks it down.
He is hot.
Pulling up and knocking him down. Connor Taddy with now 15 points. It's Falcons by three, 28-25. Antonio Morris waits for the seas to part.
Antonio Morris.
And he takes it right down the lane and scores to, again, pull the Owls to within one.
Michael Kors, Birkin, Gucci, he is in his bag.
And he's got 12 points for the Owls as Mike Rocco Grandi out in the corner. Taddy pulls up, his three rims out. A little bit of a heat check right there.
Gotta try it.
As Gonzalez pulls up, his three, no good, long rebound to Rocco Grandi, gives it up to Teddy Mangan. Mangan in the lane. Goes high off glass, but a little too strong. In transition, they get it into the corner and now up top to Morris. Morris at the elbow, gives it up to Weinberg. Weinberg's three off the back rim. And now Connor Taddy over to point guard Teddy Mangan, who will walk it over midcourt. Up top to Kozak now. Step back jumper.
Ooh, that is pretty.
Makes it 31-27. Nice offensive rebound by White. And then a foul on Gonzalez, who got pushed and will get two shots.
Foul's number two, Mike Rocco Grandi, his second, team second.
Rocco Grandi picks up his second of the night.
Eric Gonzalez to the line, shooting two.
Morris replaces Weinberg for the Owls. Gonzalez gets one of two. And we're back to a three-point game. Pennsbury 31, Bensalem 28, Suburban One League Patriot Division action on WBCB. Chris Ermer, Gus Barber, Makai Gundy in Fairless Hills, PA for you. Ty Kozak doing some heavy lifting, but ends up losing the basketball. In transition, Antonio Morris has his shot blocked from behind. Great pursuit by Zuckerman to get back defensively, and then a whistle, a foul. That foul goes on Noah Morris.
His first, team second.
Noah Morris picks up his first of the night. Both teams now with two team fouls in the second half. Zuckerman drops it off to Rocco Grandi. Goes in, pulls back out again. Around Gonzalez, runner, no good. Moffitt with the rebound, up to Gonzalez, who runs the floor and puts on the brakes. Nice look inside, he gets it to Makai White.
Makai White.
And White says, thank you very much. And it's now a 1-point game. Rocco Grandi tries to kick out to Zuckerman. But another situation where Zuckerman wasn't where the passer thought the player was going to be, and it goes out of bounds.
Yeah, I guess he's expecting him to cut, and he just didn't cut.
Antonio Morris kicks out. That one nearly deflected by Connor Taddy, but deflected right back to the Owls. Now out on the wing, Gonzalez working against Rocco Grandi. Pull-up jumper.
Eric Gonzalez
gets the shot off and gives the Owls a one-point advantage. Eric Gonzalez with 13 tonight. Zuckerman working against Moffitt. Can't hit the layup. It's rebounded by White, who gets it up the floor to Noah Morris. Morris with the dribble handoff, and Gonzalez takes over. Gonzalez guarded by Kozak, but Kozak giving him enough room, and now the ref starts the count, gives it off to Moffitt. Moffitt down low. Gets the shot and the whistle.
That's good counts. Fouls at number 10, Connor Taddy, his first, team third.
And that's got the Bensalem Owls fans who have traveled tonight to Fairless Hills in the rain.
30-second timeout, Pennsbury.
Electrified. And Pennsbury calls a timeout. 2:41 to go, third quarter in the McCaffrey's game of the night.
Don't forget, four Sixers hats, four t-shirts, four autographed photos, and four lower club level tickets.
And the Pennsbury Regional Basketball League making portions of tonight's game possible. 30 plus years, and they want to wish both the Pennsbury girls and Pennsbury boys the best of luck. It's a great way to start playing basketball. They have in-house league opportunities for kids from kindergarten all the way up to 12th grade. And then for more skilled players, they have travel opportunities for kids in grades 3 through 8. Find out more about the Pennsbury Regional Basketball League online. Go to prblonline.com. That's prblonline.com. So Jaden Moffitt at the line, looking to complete the three-point play. His shot is up and good. And it's Bensalem 35, Pennsbury 31. Cohen over to Mangan, out to Rocco Grandi. Kick out to Mangan, pull-up jumper. It's short and goes out of bounds. Valiant effort to save it. Now that shot way off the mark. And Gonzalez trying to clear out the side. And then he just loses it, throws it away. And Bensalem fouling Teddy Mangan.
Fouls number 11, Antonio Morris, his second.
Doing a little take foul right there in order to stop the fast break.
Yeah, another good job using those fouls judiciously.
Yeah, you got to be careful with that, because you don't want what happened in the first half, but them have collections too many fouls and they just get free throws off of it.
Right now, both teams with 3 team fouls in the second half. Teddy Mangan picks up the dribble, looking to go somewhere with it. Finally, gives it up to Rocco Grandi. Working against Gonzalez. Goes right around him.
Oh, what a
and lays it in. Just the speed and the quickness making the difference for Rocco Grandi. Pennsbury down by a bucket. Antonio Morris dribbles to the wing and then gives it up to Moffitt. Moffitt doing work against Connor Taddy, and he finishes through contact. Jaden Moffitt has been a handful off the bench tonight for the Bensalem Owls.
Number 4, Amir Drummond in the game. For Eric Gonzalez,
And right now, I think he recognizes with, you know, some of the Pennsbury size that he's got an opportunity to try to take anybody down low. Completes another three-point play and puts the Owls on top by five. 38-33, the score here in the McCaffrey's game of the night. Falcons around the perimeter to Cohen. Cohen out to Connor Taddy. Taddy this time working against Moffitt, and he takes him to the cup. Takes him to the dance right there with some of those moves. Makes it a three-point game. And that time, Morris is fouled and will get to the line.
Foul number one, Teddy Mangan, his third, team fifth.
So Teddy Mangan picks up foul number three.
Morris to the line, shooting two.
Connor Taddy having a whale of a game. 17 points leading all scorers. But right now his Falcons are trailing in this one. And Bensalem, they've been really good from the free throw line tonight. They're doing all the little things. That time in and out for Morris. Connor Taddy for three, off the back rim, no. Ball bounces around, picked up by Moffitt. Moffitt nearly lost it, and then it is stolen away. Good job by Cohen to get back and take it away. Mangan, Euro step, and a block is called. That goes against Drummond.
Fouls at number four, Amir Drummond, his first of team fourth.
And we'll give Mangan two looks from the line.
To the line, shooting two. Brian Zuckerman in the game for Connor Taddy.
Zuckerman in for Taddy as Mangan hits his first of two.
Cutting into a one possession game right now. Just down three.
Number 12, Jack Weinberg in the game for Makai White.
Weinberg for White.
Number 5, Sam Callahan in the game.
Teddy Mangan hits them both from the line. And it's Bensalem by a bucket, 39-37. McCaffrey's game of the night on WBCB. Morris working against Callahan. Goes left, now right. In the lane, kick out to Moffitt. Moffitt for three. Off the rim, no good. And Cohen is going to be fouled. That foul coming before the end of the quarter.
Whistle clearly before the final buzzer.
Foul number 12, Jack Weinberg, his fourth.
Weinberg picks up his fourth. And that is a costly.
Black two. Foul number two, Noah Morris, his second.
All right, that is a big difference. Instead of four on Weinberg, it's just it's two on Noah Morris. And so are they going to put like a second up on the clock here? Right now there's no time showing on the scoreboard, or actually they already have the fourth quarter up.
Yep,
there.
There's the 1 second.
All right, so they got 1 second left. Just 1 second for us in the third quarter. They get it into Zuck, but it's intercepted before Zuckerman can get it.
The end of the third quarter.
And after three quarters, It's Bensalem 39, Pennsbury 37.
We have two games here at the Falcons.
McCaffrey's game of the night on the WBCB Sports Network. We're back with quarter number four in just a moment.
BCWSA customers, former Phillies pitcher Tommy Green here. I played on the 1993 National League champs, so I know a thing or two about what it's like playing on a winning team. BCWSA has all the ingredients. They make it easy for their customers to get automatic updates by text, email, or phone anytime there is a disruption in your service area. You can even customize your alerts by going to bcwsa.net. That's bcwsa.net. BCWSA, your partner for a safer environment. BCWSA, proven.
1490 WBCB Levittown and Trenton, and video stream live at WBCBSports.com. Your home for the best local sports in Bucks and Mercer counties.
All right, welcome back to the Falcons Nest. Chris Ermer, Gus Barber, Makai Gundy, Ben Goldstein, Jordan Hirsch. Bill Redner was here for a little bit. We had the whole crew out here tonight as we have Wes Emmy's debut.
The infamous Bill Redner.
Yes, indeed.
He's a celebrity around these parts, I feel like.
No question about it. So back and forth. It was a three-point Pennsbury lead after one quarter. At halftime, it was Bensalem by a bucket. After the third quarter, it's Bensalem again by 2 points. And Bensalem first with the basketball in quarter number four. Eric Gonzalez with the dribble up top. He's out there with Weinberg, Moffitt, Morris, and White.
Hi, Merrill Reese reminds you to come back home to traditional
Falcons
Italian
with
cuisine
Callahan,
at the Revere
Cohen,
Restaurant,
Zuckerman,
802 River Road in Ewing Township.
Kozak
You'll
and Rocco Grandi.
You always feel welcome at the Revere. It's like stepping back in time where you feel
not
like
really
you're
sure
dining in South Philly or New York's
Ben
Little
Salem
Italy.
Says, hey,
start
if you want to just let us limit the number of possessions,
choose my
we're
menu
happy
featuring
to do that.
Fresh seafood dishes. Succulent
if Pennsbury doesn't
chops,
come out
or homemade pasta
to force
dish. You can even
Gonzalez
eat at the bar.
To move the,
the
ball.
Revere is open 7 days
willing to let more time come off the
private
clock.
Private room available for special affairs plus catering. For
now they do get it moving. They drop it off to Moffitt. Moffitt working against Zuckerman. Passes across the lane to Weinberg. Weinberg's pass deflected. And whistle.
To traditional Italian cuisine.
And a foul.
The Revere
called on Kozak.
802 River Road, Ewing
County. I didn't see a foul there. It looked clean.
Kozak certainly didn't think he committed a foul.
Already well on your way. Planning for your future.
For Kozak, it's his first of the night.
Growing toward
but it's the sixth team foul.
That dreams really can come true.
As the Falcons steal it,
he'll be right here with
but they're going to say out of bounds was Cohen.
Start here. Grow here. Stay here. Penn
Danny Cohen
here.
Had his foot
here
on the line.
And here we grow. Member FDIC.
McCaffrey's
so Bensalem will inbound this time
day.
From the other
Family
side of the bucket.
For over 40 years,
and they get it out there to Jack Weinberg.
Proud supporter of our local high school.
Weinberg goes left, gets cut out, gives it up
to
top to Morris.
To everyday savings on your necessary items, McCaffrey's is exceptional every day. And it's in your neighborhood in the Edgewood Village.
Morris
Shopping
dribbles
Center,
in. Back out again. He's marked by Callahan. Stops at the elbow and gives it off to Gonzalez.
And also in Blueville, Princeton, West Windsor. And the best of
Gonzalez
McCaffrey's
around a couple of defenders.
Are you living with
passes up top.
Team?
I think
Saint
that was intended
Mary,
for Weinberg. Was taken by White and then
hip replacements with a smarter process for
gives it up to
recovery.
Jack. Now Jack
earning prestigious awards for quality and diet.
Over to Morris. Morris weaving through traffic and is fouled. Goes to the floor. Kozak comes down on top of him. But everybody able to get up without too much help.
It's your help.
And the result of the play is second foul of the night on Ty Kozak.
Now you can have your BCWSA
and puts Morris at the line. He's got two looks at the bucket with 6:18 to go, fourth quarter.
Bensalem now in the bonus.
Printing up to 13 months of your previous bill. Best of all, the service is free. Sign up for e-billing at bcwsa.net.
It's his first of two.
BCWSA, prove it.
You're not just building a company.
Gives them 15 for tonight.
To build your community. For 150 years, Penn Community Bank has been strengthening our region, serving as a trusted partner and resource for businesses like yours. Our team of business bankers can get you where you need to go. Real relationships, expert advice.
So Rocco Grandi to the bench. Teddy Mangan back out on the floor for Coach Emmy. Morris makes both of his free throw attempts. And Bensalem by four, 41-37. Kozak kick out. Going inside there was Callahan. Falcons wanted a whistle. Gonzalez with a little nifty dribbling just in front of us. Teddy Mangan, I mean, it looks like he's close enough. I'm not sure why he wasn't getting counted. And now it's the Falcons with a takeaway, but then they give it right away.
And right back.
Right back again. Going inside there was Callahan. And they're going to call a jump ball. And the Pennsbury Falcons have the possession arrow, so they'll hold on to it.
For Sam Callahan.
Wild series right there. Teams exchanged turnovers.
Wild sequence.
Falcons get it into the post to Kozak. Kozak with the left hand scoops it home. That's just a scorer's touch right there. And it's back to a two-point game. Mekhi White from the free throw line. Off the front rim, no good. Zuckerman with a great rebound over Moffitt. Up to Connor Taddy. Taddy up top to Kozak. Kozak drives. Can't finish, but give him a trip to the line. As at the blocking foul on Jack Weinberg.
12, Jack Weinberg is fourth.
That is number four on Weinberg. Comes with just under 5 minutes remaining.
It's pressure time for Pennsbury right here. Got an opportunity to tie this game up with the free throws.
Shooting two. Jack Weinberg.
Amir Drummond checks in. Weinberg to the bench. Figured with those four fouls, he was going to have to sit down for a little bit. Coach Morris can keep him in this back pocket for the final few minutes if he wants to make sure he preserves Weinberg without fouling out. And Kozak misses both free throws, but it's Connor Taddy with an offensive rebound. Kozak spinning, kick out, Taddy for three. Yes!
Taddy for three!
Falcons up 42-41. Gonzalez nearly had it taken away, gets it to Moffitt, and then Moffitt doing some heavy lifting. Puts the Owls back up by a point, 43-42.
This is just a crazy game we're watching tonight, Chris.
Great contest here. SOL Patriot Division action as Mangan hands off to Zuckerman, up top to Cohen. Mangan jumper, little too strong. Zuckerman fighting for possession. To the floor goes Gonzalez. Morris, the beneficiary of the pass, and then a foul as Ty Kozak with the reach in.
Ty Kozak is third.
So Kozak picks up foul number three.
Number two, Noah Morris in the game. For the Owls. Number two, Mike Robert Grandy in the game. For Danny Cohen. Antonio Morris to the line.
Just under 4 minutes left tonight. McCaffrey's game of the night on WBCB. Morris, 1-1, hits the front end. I mean, if Bensalem can hold on, I think you're going to look at one of the things. The free throw shooting has benefited Bensalem. That time, though, Ty Kozak with the rebound, runs the floor, hands off to Mangan. Mangan shot altered by Moffitt, and then Moffitt with the rebound. Moffitt to the baseline, and then a timeout taken by Bensalem. Comes with 3:37 to go in the fourth quarter. Bensalem 44, Pennsbury 42. And Complete Automotive Service. Trust the Peruzzi Auto Group for value and service on all makes and models. Free multi-point inspection on your vehicle with any paid service. A 10% military and law enforcement discount on any service by 3 tires. Get the fourth free. All service performed by certified technicians. Peruzzi, with big comfy waiting rooms, and they also have free Wi-Fi. You can do early drop-off. Peruzzi service open Monday through Friday from 7:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. Saturdays open 7:30 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. Peruzzi Auto Group, service for all makes and models. Visit a Peruzzi dealership on Business Route 1 in Fairless Hills, where their business is you. Owls get it into Gonzalez. Gonzalez dribbles away from the bucket. Now getting counted, goes around Zuckerman, puts on the brakes, goes to the left. Out to Morris. Morris driving. Kick out. And the Owls kind of pull the cord there and slow it down again. They give it to Moffitt. Moffitt has it taken away. Mangan runs the floor and carries. Was it a carry or a clear out? Now they're going to call offensive foul.
Yeah, they're going to call an offensive foul there.
Man, great opportunity there for Pennsbury.
No full court pressure by Pennsbury here.
They get it into Drummond, and then Drummond's pass deflected out of bounds by Ty Kozak. Pennsbury dialing up the defensive intensity as they get it in to Gonzalez, who takes it end to end. His layup attempt is no good, and it's rebounded by Callahan. Sam Callahan with a big board. Ty Kozak over midcourt. Goes around Drummond.
Oh, what a move. Clear those with the left.
And we're tied up 44-44 with 2:22 remaining. Whistle, foul called on Callahan. And that's going to be double bonus. Team foul number 10. And so Gonzalez steps up to the line for two shots.
Number one, Eric Gonzalez to the line. Shooting two.
That foul differential is a problem for Pennsbury. Every time now they foul Bensalem, they're giving him two looks. Next foul that Bensalem commits, they will put the Falcons at the line for a 1-1. Eric Gonzalez misses the first.
Number one, Teddy Mangan, Falcons.
Weinberg does come back out on the floor, so Jack Weinberg, one of the Bensalem starters, out there with four fouls. As Gonzalez gets one of two to make it a one-point game. 45-44, Bensalem on top of Pennsbury. Owls trying to keep their unblemished record. Kick out, wide open look. Mangan can't hit. And then underneath, a whistle, a foul, as Ty Kozak goes to the floor.
And now, Pennsbury is in the bonus.
Foul's at number two, Noah Morris, his third.
Noah Morris picks up his third. And yeah, now a 1-1.
Which is crucial for a team like Pennsbury, who so far in the start of the season has not had great success on the free throw stripe. But if you want any guy right there on there right now, Ty Kozak is one of them, even though he hasn't had the best of luck so far.
Ties it up, 45-45, and gets the bonus shot. And he hasn't been great from the line, but talk about a clutch player, a guy with, he's got the ice in his veins. No moment is too big for Ty Kozak. Let's see if he lives up to that hype with this second shot. No, in and out that time. And it remains 45 apiece. 2 minutes left in the McCaffrey's game of the night.
Both teams hitting 1-1. They might be hitting free throws at their next practice.
Gonzalez has it taken away by Teddy Mangan. Sliding to the floor. What a great play by Antonio Morris. He came out of nowhere to take that one back for the Owls. Gonzalez now in the corner, and they're going to call contact on Ryan Zuckerman. I think that's kind of a heady varsity play by a guard like Eric Gonzalez. His quickness, giving him the advantage, because, I mean, they were in a tight window down there, and he gets himself to the line for two looks.
But what a hustle on the other end by number two, Morris, to get that ball, keep it in bounds, and pass it to his teammate. Wow, just crazy.
Well, now the Owls have gone cold at the line. Noah Morris to the bench. Mekhi White back out on the floor.
Just crucial moments for both teams right now. Free throws are definitely paying a dividend.
And Eric Gonzalez, one of two, puts the Owls back in front, 46-45. Mangan dribbles over midcourt, and the Pennsbury Falcons take a timeout. Comes with 1:27 to go. A full timeout on the floor. And for complete automotive service, trust the Peruzzi Auto Group for value and service on all makes and models. Free multi-point inspection on your vehicle with any paid service. 10% military and law enforcement discounts on any service. Buy three tires, get the fourth free. All service performed by certified technicians. Peruzzi has big comfy waiting rooms at their dealerships with free Wi-Fi and early drop-off. Peruzzi service open Monday through Friday from 7:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. Saturday is open 7:30 to 4:30 in the afternoon. Peruzzi Auto Group, service for all makes and models. Visit a Peruzzi dealership on Business Route 1 in Fairless Hills, where our business is you.
I bought my new car at Peruzzi.
Yeah, I got a Peruzzi. I got to get a new Peruzzi, though.
I just got a new Peruzzi.
Nice. Well, you can also trust them for all the great service that they do, for sure. Check out one of their dealerships on Business Route 1. We thank them for their support of high school athletics on BCB. Falcons trailing by a point. And Ty Kozak will inbound. Gets the handoff from Zuckerman. Kozak around defenders. Can't hit, close to the rim. Keeps it alive. Connor Taddy Now over to Rocco Grandi. Rocco Grandi nearly got it knocked away. Back up top to Ty Kozak. Connor Taddy, three, not that time. And the rebound for Moffitt. Nice outlet up to Gonzalez, and Gonzalez fouled. And Ty Kozak called for his fourth.
Fouls number 15, Ty Kozak is fourth.
Comes with 53 seconds remaining tonight.
Number one, Eric Gonzalez to the line, shooting two.
And you see Coach Wes Emmy saying, you know, we don't have to foul. Gonzalez at the line, comes up short.
And that's a big miss right there. Because even if he does make the second one, it's still only a two-point possession game.
Shot is up and good. Gets one of two. And it is Bensalem by 2 points. 47-45. Teddy Mangan races it up the floor, fires the three. It's no good. And the Owls have it. Makai White has it, and then the timeout is taken by Bensalem.
Full timeout, Bensalem.
So they're going to talk about the end game as we have 33.9 seconds on the fourth quarter clock. Boy, this one has lived up to the hype. Toy drive night, Joey Monahan moment of silence night, travel night. Pennsbury 31% from three.
I got goosebumps at this game. This is crazy.
McCaffrey's Food Market's exceptional every day. Tonight is the McCaffrey's game of the night. And we're coming in for a landing. Because this one's still hanging in the balance. I gotta imagine for Pennsbury, they're gonna try to foul right away, but that sometimes that strategy will change when the opposition is in the double bonus already. But at the same time, you save clock at this point.
Yeah, it's just like, what else is there more to do? Like, strategy-wise talking.
You gotta try to lengthen the game.
Yep.
Maybe go for the steal here as they will successfully inbound to Eric Gonzalez. Gonzalez dribbles up top, dribbles around, trapped in the corner, and he's fouled. Callahan gets him with the reach in and puts Gonzalez at the line for two.
Foul number five, Sam Callahan, his second. Eric Gonzalez to the line, shooting two.
So Eric Gonzalez here with one, two, three, four. Four free throws in the second half. And he's got 16 points. Make that 17.
Number three, Makai White in the game.
Makes it a three-point game. And this shot would be big if he could make it a two-possession affair. He gets the bounce.
Oh, I think right here you look for a quick three if I'm Pennsbury.
Mangan over midcourt. Over to Kozak. Kozak drives. Wow, blocking foul called on Moffitt. That'll send Kozak to the line.
34, Jaden Moffitt is second.
Moffitt picks up his second. So with 14 seconds to go, Kozak will get two free throws. And they got to clean up a little moisture, dry up the moisture on the floor. So they got that housekeeping taken care of. Makes it a three-point game with that one. And the Falcons are going to take another timeout. Yes. Full timeout for Pennsbury. I don't think we talk about DiLorenzo's enough. They're so good over there. And they support all the high school football, basketball, baseball that we have on BCB. And they're right there at 8919 New Falls Road in Levittown, owned and operated by Tyler DiLorenzo. You can call in, take out. They have the original Trenton tomato pie over there. Other great gourmet pizzas as well. In the Vermilion Square, DiLorenzo's, the Berg Pizza. You know, we were over in Trenton today for Trenton Today, talking with Mayor Gussiora from Trenton Central High School. And we got some tornado basketball coming up on WBCB. Yeah, I think next week, and they were actually talking about DiLorenzo's and the great tradition of that tomato pie, and they're all kind of sad that DiLorenzo's moved out of Trenton, but
yeah.
It's for our benefit, you know.
We love it.
Yeah, it's all good in Fairless Hills, and we thank DiLorenzo's for their outstanding support of Pennsbury Athletics as we're down to the final 14 seconds. Back to the free throw line goes Ty Kozak. He gets one more opportunity. He can cut it to two. Shot is up. In and out. No good. Rebounded by Noah Morris, who sends it over to Antonio Morris, who gets a bump from behind. That's a foul. And Antonio Morris to the line for two. And that foul comes with
11,
just under 11
Morris
seconds remaining. Now, Pennsbury led after the first quarter, but since then, Bensalem, they've gone back and forth. Ball goes in and out. Makes the second free throw critical. It could again stretch it to a two-possession game or give Pennsbury an opportunity to tie this thing up with a three-pointer. In and out. 10 seconds to go. Kozak for three, short, and it's rebounded by Drummond. Drummond is fouled with 2.5 seconds to go. And Ty Kozak looking disappointed with himself.
Number four, Amir Drummond to the line, shooting two. That
shot wasn't a little bit more within range or so now here's Amir Drummond looking to pretty much ice this thing. Nope.
Honestly, with the way the night he's had, I'm surprised they didn't give the ball to Connor Toddy right there with that final shot. Three-point shooters had a hot hand tonight. But then Kozak is one of your top dogs.
I mean, right here, 2.6 remaining. Even with a miss, the Falcons should have enough time to advance the ball, maybe get a shot off. It's missed. Connor Taddy.
No!
And that's the ball game. Bensalem wins 49-46. Dropping the Pennsbury Falcons now to 2-3 overall, and Bensalem stays unblemished, 5-0 here this season for the Owls. All right, stay with us. We're going to talk to a couple of our Pennsbury players of the game. And it's brought to you by DiLorenzo's Pizza. We'll return in just a little bit on the WBCB Sports Network.
1490 WBCB Levittown and Trenton, and video stream live at WBCBSports.com. Your home for the best local sports in Bucks and Mercer counties.
Jefferson Health has been serving Northeast Philadelphia and Bucks County for more than a century. Their Frankfort, Tarsdale, and Bucks Hospital locations are there for you with primary and specialty care, emergency care, and of course, inpatient care. Wherever you live, work, or play, Jefferson Health is there with exceptional care. Jefferson is where you are. Call 1-800-JEFF-NOW to schedule an appointment or visit jeffersonhealth.org.
Hi, Merrill Reese remind you to come back home to traditional Italian cuisine at the Revere Restaurant, 802 River Road in Ewing Township. You'll always feel welcome at the Revere. It's like stepping back in time where you'll feel like you're dining in South Philly or New York's Little Italy. Start your meal with complimentary Hoboken bread. Choose from a menu featuring fresh seafood dishes, succulent steaks and chops, or homemade pasta dishes. You can even eat at the bar. The Revere is open 7 days for lunch and dinner. Private room available for special affairs, plus catering. For reservations, call 609-882-6365. That's 609-882-6365. Come home to traditional Italian cuisine. The Revere Restaurant, 802 River Road, Ewing Township.
Whether you're just getting started, already well on your way, planning for your future, drafting your vision, growing toward greatness, or finding that dreams really can come true. Whatever your next steps are, we'll be right here with you, just like we have been for 150 years. Start here, grow here, stay here. Penn Community Bank. Here we are, and here we grow. Member FDIC.
McCaffrey's Food Markets, exceptional every day. Family-owned and operated for over 40 years, McCaffrey's is part of your community and a very proud supporter of our local high schools. For true value on the freshest meats and produce to their own prepared food department, to everyday savings on your necessary items, McCaffrey's is exceptional every day. And it's in your neighborhood in the Edgewood Village Shopping Center, 635 Hecock Road, Yardley. The Villages of Newtown at 2890 South Eagle Road, and also in Bluebell, Princeton, West Windsor, and the best of McCaffrey's in Doylestown. Are you living with relentless pain? St. Mary has a new way to help. Knee and hip replacements with a smarter process for faster recovery, earning prestigious awards for quality and value. A rapid recovery program has you walking just hours after surgery, and breakthrough advances such as custom fit joints position you for a longer pain-free life. 215-710-5888. St. Mary Orthopedics. It's your health.
Well, the Falcons disappeared into the locker room quickly, and maybe we'll try to grab one of those guys for our DiLorenzo's Players of the Game. Connor Taddy is our Pennsbury player. He led the team with 17 points tonight, but it was not enough as they fall to the Owls 49-46. For Bensalem, they got big contributions from Eric Gonzalez, had 18 points. Antonio Morris with 16, and double digits for Jaden Moffitt, who came off the bench and scored 11 points. And Moffitt really was a difference maker in this game. His size and presence down low, there were times where he was kind of undefendable for the Falcons, and actually not only was he able to score, but finish through contact and get himself to the line a few times.
Yeah, really good job with using his size to his advantage, and he was just having his way down there in the post. Obviously, Zuckerman trying to do as much as he can with him, just a little overpowering with him.
Well, again, final score 49-46, thanks to Jefferson Health, McCaffrey's Supermarket, Penn Community Bank, Rob's Automotive and Collision, BCWSA, St. Mary Medical Center, the Revere Restaurant, Team Toyota, the Peruzzi Auto Group, the Trentonian, Jammer Doors, and the Pennsbury Basketball Parents Club. Oh, don't want to forget DiLorenzo's on New Falls Road. Got a couple of gift certificates. We'll pass those along to our Pennsbury players of the game. Falcons falling to 2-3. They're back to action next Tuesday, taking on Council Rock South. And for the Bensalem Owls, 5-0, a great start to their season. Congratulations to the Owls on the win tonight. But man, a back and forth night. I think things for Pennsbury to look at and grow from, but you either can grow, Coach Emmy told me earlier, you either grow from a loss or you grow from a win. And unfortunately tonight, they're going to have to try to rebuild after falling to this Owls team, a really good Bensalem bunch.
Yeah, just a really hard-fought battle today. Just going to have to take this in stride, learn from it, and just know you put your best foot out there.
Thanks to the crew, Gus Barber doing our video engineering, Makai Gundy, our cameraman. Thanks to Jordan Hirsch and to Ben Goldstein, our statisticians tonight. And thanks to you for being with us as well. Our final score from Pennsbury High School, it was the Bensalem Owls 49 and the Pennsbury Falcons 46. Thanks for listening and watching Pennsbury Falcon basketball on the WBCB Sports Network.